Thank you to Cometeer for sponsoring today's episode. Cometeer offers barista-quality coffee that's delivered in frozen, 100% curbside recyclable aluminum capsules. Click the link in the description and you will get $20 off your first purchase, plus free shipping. That's 10 free cups of coffee and over 30% off. Earlier this week, NASA's James Webb Space Telescope successfully deployed its primary mirror, which was the last major maneuver on the way to being a functioning space telescope. If you want to know about what's next for Webb, we will have an entire episode dedicated just to that on our space channel later this month, SciShow Space. Meanwhile, back here on Earth, scientists recently pulled a mind-boggling discovery out of thin air. Literally. Two independent groups of scientists successfully detected the presence of animal species by measuring their DNA in the air. The scientists were trying to see if they could detect and identify individual animal species just from the bits of their genome circulating in the environment. All organisms shed DNA through things like their skin, urine, saliva, and pollen, and this DNA that they leave behind is called environmental DNA, or eDNA. And by measuring the eDNA in permafrost, soil, even honey, researchers can figure out what organisms are present in an ecosystem. That gives them a picture of the health of an ecosystem without having to tromp around and actually find every single organism living in it. This method of monitoring populations of organisms has been especially useful in aquatic ecosystems. Scientists can just collect the water, catalog the DNA in it, and get a sense of the biodiversity of the area, which is pretty dang convenient. So in two studies done in Europe, scientists decided to see if they could try something similar on land by measuring eDNA present in the air. So to do this, first they collected air samples at two European zoos by just vacuuming it. Just vacuuming up the air. That air entered the vacuum through a filter, which trapped all the little bits of skin cells and saliva and poop that contained DNA. Then they took those filters back to the lab, extracted the DNA, and sequenced the genomes to see whose DNA showed up. Now, they weren't very optimistic that this would work. At least one of the teams fully expected that it would not work at all. But it didn't just work, it worked remarkably well. Both teams identified dozens of species. Some were hundreds of meters away from the collection site. Others were housed inside buildings. And some were dead, like chickens and cows, which only exist in the zoo as dinner for the carnivores. The teams also detected wild species living outside the zoo, and in one case, researchers even picked up DNA from an endangered hedgehog living nearby in the wild. Now, these were just proof-of-concept studies, so there are still some kinks to work out, like finding ways to reduce the risk of a sample getting contaminated. Scientists will also need to replicate the results in different types of environments before we know just how well it works. But even so, the fact that two research labs did this independently and found similar success strengthens the results here, and it suggests that these studies could have huge implications for conservation. See, traditional methods for surveying ecosystems involve going into field sites and physically observing the species present. That's invasive and can damage the ecosystem. Plus, it's imperfect. It's really easy to miss small or endangered species, and it relies on experts who can personally identify a ton of different kinds of species. But if scientists can monitor ecosystems just by measuring the air, that would be a safer, more reliable way to keep track of species moving into or out of an area. And it would let us look out for endangered species and even species that may or may not be extinct. Speaking of extinct species, last month paleontologists made an amazing discovery about a species that is definitely extinct. An international team of researchers examined an exceptionally preserved theropod egg from southern China. Theropods are the group of dinosaurs that includes T-Rex and raptors, and they are the ancestors of modern-day birds. And in this theropod egg, there was an exceptionally preserved theropod embryo. Like one of the most complete embryos of its kind ever discovered. Finding dinosaur skeletons in eggs is super rare, but when it happens, these skeletons can reveal a lot about the dinosaur's reproduction and development. And that offers a lot of clues about dinosaurs' relationship to modern animals. This embryo was unearthed in the storage room of a museum in China where it had been hanging out for a decade. Researchers affectionately named it Baby Yingliang, after the museum it was found inside of. Baby Yingliang is about 24 centimeters long, from the top of its head to the bottom of its spine. It's nestled in the egg, with its head tucked down around its pelvis, its legs folded up next to its head, and its spine following the curve of the egg. This posture is actually pretty surprising, because it has never been seen in dinosaurs before, but it is actually really similar to a position that we see in modern birds. Modern birds adjust themselves into this position shortly before they hatch, and taking on this shape is critical for hatching successfully. No other theropod embryos have ever been found with skeletons in this position. This discovery hints that theropods might have done something similar, repositioning themselves right before they hatched. This is the first evidence that a non-bird species might have had this same tucking behavior, and the researchers think this might indicate that the behavior actually evolved in theropods way before birds. They'll need to look at more embryos to confirm that hypothesis, though, so for now, it's still just incubating. Thank you for watching this episode of SciShow, and thanks to today's sponsor, Cometeer. Cometeer offers barista-quality coffee that is super convenient, brewed 10 times stronger than regular coffee, and delivered in frozen, recyclable aluminum capsules. Cometeer sources their coffee from some of the world's best specialty coffee roasters. It's ground and brewed, and then immediately flash frozen to lock in freshness and flavor. So all you have to do is add hot water for a nice hot coffee, or you can let it melt and pour it over cold water for an iced coffee or milk for a latte. The supply chain is sustainability focused, and every component of the package you receive is 100% curbside recyclable. And Cometeer turns all the coffee grounds produced in this process into compost for local gardens. Their process is designed to reduce waste at every step, from bean to bin. If you're interested in trying out Cometeer, you can get $20 off your first purchase, plus free shipping when you click our link. That's 10 free cups of coffee and over 30% off.